Hi everyone, how are you all? In this video, we will take a look at the Ranga Splendor. This pen is manufactured by the Indian pen manufacturer Ranga Pens. Mr. Kandan from Ranga Pens loaned me this pen for me to voice my honest opinion about this pen, and I will be returning this pen back to him once I am done with this review. So this is not a paid review, and I will be talking about the looks, features and material used for this pen, as well as size comparisons and writing samples for the pen. So let's get on with it. So let us talk about the looks of this pen. This pen is a torpedo shaped pen, and this is a very classic shape. It is very streamlined and it helps hide some of the size of this pen. If you want, you can get this pen in two other variants. Those two are a little bit more cylindrical than this one. One is rounded at both ends and the other is slightly peaked at the both ends. So the first thing that comes to your mind when you see this pen and hold it is the size of this pen. As you can see, it completely it fills my hand completely. Let me give you the dimensions. So capped, this is about more than 17 centimeters, I would say around 173 millimeters. Uncapped, it is a little over 15 centimeters, I would say 150 millimeters approx. And the cap diameter is 19 millimeters, and the barrel at its thickest is 17.5 millimeters. The grip section is an hourglass shape, and it is 13 millimeters at the holding part, and 15 millimeters where it flares to meet the nib. Here is a photograph of the section of the nib taken head on. The nib may look small in comparison to the girth of the grip section, but it is a size 6 nib. Here are the photographs of this pen's girth in terms of its diameter from the cross section. This is from inside the cap, and this one is inside the barrel. So as you can see, there is a lot of material that has been used in the making of this pen. So let's do a size comparison of this pen with other fountain pens. Here is the Splendor alongside a Twisby Eco, alongside a Pilot Metropolitan. This is a Lamy Safari. So these are very famous pens. Very commercial, very mainstream. I also have some Ranga pens. So this is model 3C. This is model 4. And this is Bamboo. And as you can see, these three models also are quite large in their own right. But these three are overshadowed by this one. Now let me show you the opposite spectrums of the pens here with me. This is a Pilot Prera. This is a very small petite pen. This one has to be posted for anyone to write with it. So this is a fun comparison between these two. As you can see, the pen is quite large and unwieldy. It is impossible to put this pen in a shirt pocket. When by pocket, I should show you the clip of this pen. It is it has quite a lot of spring to it, very usable, but it is a little too short with comparison to the size of the cap of this pen and to the overall body. You may get away with putting it in a jeans or trouser pocket, but I will recommend putting this pen in a pen sleeve or in a bag or in a pouch and take it with you wherever you want to go. So let us talk about the features of this pen now. So this pen, it features an inner cap inside, which along with the flaring of this grip section, it allows to lock this nib inside so that the nib stays moist for long periods of storage. And another feature that this pen has is that it has multi-start threads. So what that means is that all you have to do is one full rotation and that's it. About one full rotation is required to completely unscrew this pen's cap from the body, which is a big deal for a pen of this size. For example, let me give you a comparison with another screw in cap pen from Ranga. This is model 4. This takes 1, 2, 3, around 3.5 turns to open. So if you are using a pen as a daily driver, it really means a lot if you can easily screw and unscrew the pen. But in daily usage, it turns out to be a boon, this feature. And then we could go to the filling mechanism for this pen. This pen is a 3-in-1 filler, which means it can be filled in 3 ways. So the first way is the one that I am using right now. This is to fill the pen with a converter. This is an international converter by Schmidt. You can also use international standard cartridges, or if you want, you can use this pen's barrel and to hold ink in a way that it becomes an eyedropper. So you simply take this converter out and use this barrel to hold the ink. Well, and to that end, the manufacturer also provides silicone grease on these threads, so that when you use this pen as an eyedropper, the pen does not leak. And even if there was no silicone grease, these threads are plentiful and very precise. So I would say that even without silicone grease, this pen will not leak, most probably. So let's talk about the material used in this pen. This is what Ranga Pens calls cracked ice acrylic, and it has cracks in the body of the acrylic, as you can see. And this is a little different than the one that I have on this model 4. In the model 4, you can see fairly homogeneous pattern, but in this one, there are alternate patterns of different color. So there are alternate patterns of cream and this lovely chocolate brown black color. If you want, you can have some other options of materials as well, like this normal cracked ice acrylic, or there are other multicolor acrylics as well, where there will be a swirl of couple of colors or more than 2 colors. So those will be having a wavy pattern. And there is also clear acrylic if you want. That will be a completely clear body, like this Twisby Eco. And also, if you want, you can have it in ebonite. Ranga Pens also has around 40 different patterns of ebonite material with them. So a lot of options for the materials of the pen. They have actually 80 different kind of options in acrylic. So a total of 130 different options for materials if you want. So let us go ahead with the writing sample of this pen. So this is a 90 GSM dotted paper, and I completely forgot, this is a size 6 Yovo nib in medium point. You can also have it in extra fine, broad, and 1.1 millimeter stub. The same options are also available for Bock nibs if you like Bock nibs more. And let's go ahead. So, as I can say, after having written some definitely feel that this pen is quite comfortable when you start writing with it. This big section, it actually helps grip the pen in a more comfortable way than with the normal usual pens. Let me just do a quick writing sample, fast writing. So as you can see, there is no skipping. Let me just do a flex test. So this nib does not flex much. You can get some flex out of it, but it feels unnatural with the amount of effort you have to put in to create this kind of line variation, which is not much. The nib is smooth otherwise and doesn't seem to be having any scratchiness issues, and let me do some reverse writing. So this nib becomes an ultra extra fine from medium point when you reverse write. You can reverse write with it, but it's very scratchy that way. So the Ranga Splendor is a large pen to the point of being a giant sized pen. You will definitely find it hard to put it in your shirt or trouser or jeans pockets. But once that is out of the way, the pen simply delights when you start writing with it. It is very comfortable to hold and write, and features like 3-in-1 filling system, German nib and feed system, inner cap, multi-start threads. These all combined make this pen quite a practical buy actually. So a big thanks to Mr. Kandan for lending me this expensive pen for review, and thanks to all of you for watching this video. If you have any question regarding this pen or how to order it, please feel free to write to me in the comment section below. Thank you and have a great day. Bye. Let me show you how these German screw-in type nibs can be interchanged. So I have this Ranga model bamboo. This has a 1.5mm stub nib. This is also a Yovo size 6 nib. And these size 6 nibs are interchangeable. But the Yovo nibs are not interchangeable with Bock nibs or Schmidt nibs. So let me give you an example. So this one, this is a Bock. This is a Yovo. These two are not interchangeable. And that is because there are differences in the shape of the nib housing and the threads. So what you do is you first grab a paper towel and you grab the nib and the feed such that you grab them from the top and bottom, and don't grab the nib from its two sides like so. Don't do it like this. Do it top and bottom such that the misalignment between the nib and the feed is not there when you twist the whole thing out. So it's not a big deal, as you can always realign the nib later. So anyway, hold the nib and the feed in the top and bottom. And now after holding, simply rotate the body of the pen in clockwise direction. This direction is when you're looking from the nib. Simply rotate the body of the pen in clockwise direction, and very soon the nib and the complete feed system, this is out of the body. So this is a screw-in nib and feed system from Yovo, and you can see the threads here which are visible, and the nib and feed are actually friction fit within this housing. So you can simply pull the nib and feed out from the housing to align the feed with the nib if required. So now let's do the same with the bamboo. So hold the nib from top and bottom and twist the body of the pen clockwise. So now we have So these two screw-in systems, these both are Yovo. One is a medium nib and one is 1.5 millimeter nib. Now let us interchange these nib systems. So now I will be putting the 1.5 millimeter stub in the Splendor. Just insert it and rotate the body counterclockwise this time. Better use a hand towel. Now this, there you go. So there you have it. Now the Splendor has the Yovo 1.5 millimeter stub nib. So this is the fun and practicality of these German screw-in type nibs. You can order a pen with a specific nib, but then you can exchange the whole nib system at a moment's notice, really. Let me just give you a quick writing sample for this. So this is now 1.5 millimeter stub. There you go.